minute. When do you want to rock? When? Tell me when. When do you want to rock?
I want to rock right now.
It's time for the 10-minute drill. We'll do just that. By the way, a pair of tickets to the Kiss Farewell Tour. That's at the arena coming up in April.
Yeah, April 12th.
Big show.
Still up in the air. Shannon Tweed
may be rocking at the arena.
Shannon Tweed may indeed be there. So, kids, keep your fingers crossed on that one.
Kids don't care, but we do.
Yes, we do. Single-handedly kept an entire network in business. So, she's always got that. All right. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to play the 10-minute drill. It's a rapid fire. Well, you know, sometimes rapid fire. But we're going to hit on the hottest issues in town as we drive the sports narrative in Jacksonville today.
Let's set the tone.
What do you think? Yeah, let's be some tone setters. All right, you ready?
That's bold, Jeff.
Thank you. That's what we're trying to do. That's what we've been tasked with.
Yes.
All right, listen, Dan, the trade deadline has come and gone.
Yes.
And with the Jaguars doing a little bit of selling and no buying, is this any indication that they've lost optimism in this season?
They lost optimism. I think they've lost optimism, Jeff, because of their record. I think they've lost optimism because of the way they've played. I don't think this particular move is a white flag waiver. I think they feel like they can win or lose without Dante Fowler Jr., who has made very little impact so far through 8 games this season. Remember, he sat out the first game and has only 2 sacks and is not really playing that much either.
I was thinking more in terms of not getting, you know, that word is they may kick tires on some, you know, some veteran quarterbacks.
Yeah.
You know, a tight end, a linebacker. They didn't add anything.
If they had traded for Tyrod Taylor, would he be starting this Sunday or next Sunday at Indy? I don't know. Huh?
I would hope.
Yeah, I wouldn't think so.
But what about a linebacker? Or, you know, another area
of need? To take whose spot? Leon Jacobs?
Just to have one.
Game? Yeah. What are you going to give up to get him?
Yeah, I don't know.
You know, so I
no buying, though, is the point.
Yeah, I get you, but I don't think, you know, I don't know what more you were going to. I think they made their move. They went for Carlos Hyde, and obviously it's a bad optic right now because they didn't use him in the first game.
Shut you down!
I suspect at some point they.
You know, Carlos Hyde had one of the best short yardage percentages, and they had all those short yards at the end. They didn't even use them.
Oh, yeah.
Oof.
Listen, a couple coaches in the news. A couple of former Gators, Urban Meyer, who, you know, I said the other day, looked tired and old, you know, and apparently we find out why. We've seen this narrative before. He's dealing with some medical issues, and this is, you know, it's not anytime it's something on your brain, it's a fairly.
Sure.
I guess my question is, I'll start with him, is Urban Meyer coaching Ohio State next season?
You know, that timeline is interesting. If you ask me, is Urban Meyer coaching at Ohio State in 3 years, I would definitively tell you no. Yeah. Urban's track record has been to really debate it internally and then without full commitment go ahead and coach next year and then that'll be it. So I would say because he's been asked and he said definitively yes and he, as he showed in Gainesville, is willing to half-heartedly see if he can get his mojo back. You know, and by half-heartedly, I just mean – not sure whether or not it's something that he wants to commit to. Listen, I think we're at the stage, and I mean this seriously. I'm not being funny. Urban Meyer may need quick coaching for his own life, for his own health. Dan.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I mean, he is clearly one of those guys
he's
that
wound tight,
it
man.
Eats him up.
Yeah.
I mean, and
I bet if you took a like the President of the United States picture. You know, when he starts and when he, 4 years later and how old they've aged.
Yeah, or a TV editor, same thing.
I bet if you took a picture of Urban Meyer when he went to Ohio State, all refreshed and feeling good and how he looks now, I bet it's a very, very noticeable difference. I say he's not. I don't think he's going to be coaching there.
All right, Dan, clearly the first four in the playoff rankings will not be the final four. It can't.
Right.
You got LSU and LSU and Alabama playing this week.
Right.
You have other factors. They're gonna. So, considering where we are and using this as the base point, I think we can agree that it'll be Alabama and Clemson are going to hold their spots. They may not, but let's just assume they are.
Okay.
Who are the other two teams going to be in a month?
The two teams that make the Final Four. To lose to Alabama and Clemson, who will play for another natty.
Probably, although Clemson is gettable, I think, more than Bama.
You want a definitive answer?
No, I want you to give your best guess because there is no definitive answer. That's kind of the point. This first playoff release is stupid. It serves no purpose.
You got to do it at some point.
Yeah.
I would say.
Do you?
Yeah.
How about after the season do it?
Well, I would say Michigan. Listen, look at all the chatter it gets. It's smart, actually, in that respect. I would say the Michigan Ohio State winner can still get in.
Will get in?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't think either of those. Now, Michigan has Penn State this weekend, but I think the Michigan Ohio State winner will get in. And because I think they'll only have one loss. And then I'm not willing to grab another SEC team. I think it's going to be somebody else.
I take it you think Notre Dame's going to lose and fall out of this.
Well, I said that the other day, so I hate to go back on it, but if I had to pick one, I'd still pick Notre Dame.
Okay, well, that's fair. I would, too.
Yeah, I would pick Notre Dame.
I suspect they're going to lose, but...
Yeah, they got at Northwestern this week. They've got... Tough isn't the fair word, but it's challenging each... You know, it's a good team, good team, good team, good team left on their schedule, as far as I can remember. It's SC, Syracuse,
Stanford. Right? Or they play them already?
They played them.
No, FSU.
FSU.
And Northwestern.
FSU may be the easiest one of them.
They are the easiest one of them.
Good Lord. Yeah, I don't think Northwestern's going to get them. I don't think FSU's going to get them. But Syracuse or SC, you know, SC's wobbling. Syracuse is a pretty good team, man. Be careful with Syracuse.
I agree with that.
Be careful. But of those four, I still kind of think they'll lose one.
I would think so, too.
Yeah.
So. If they have a win over Michigan, could they lose this week and still get in? A lot of football has to happen. Here's what happens with Notre Dame, too, and whether it's fair or unfair or whether it helps them or hurts them, while these other teams are posturing with conference championship games and either bolstering their case or getting knocked out, you know, Notre Dame will just sit there and watch because they don't have to play a conference championship game, which is patently unfair compared to the rest of the teams. If you're Alabama or Georgia, you got to prove it one more time where, you know.
Bless you.
Whereas you don't if you're Notre Dame.
Nick Saban turned 67 years old today. In honor of Nick Saban, just a few thoughts, concepts, and rationalizations on him.
Now, there were some people that thought he was going to go from age 6'6 to 6'6'6, but
yes,
he did turn to
6'7.
Okay,
yes,
all right.
First off, how much longer do you think he coaches? And secondly, what is the most impressive thing to you about Nick Saban? Like, what is the most impressive stat, most impressive?
The consistency, consistent excellence I've never seen from not Bear Bryant, not Steve Spurrier, not Bobby Bowden, none of them. This guy in the hardest league in college sports.
It's amazing.
The only thing that comes close would be ACC basketball, and it does not have the regular season pressure that SEC football has. So it is that. It's the consistent excellence. And not consistently contending. Mm-hmm. I mean, they've been every playoff.
Yeah.
Three of them.
Well, this is the fourth Final Four, and they'll be in this for the fourth straight time.
Yeah.
This is, you know, he's 10-4 in bowl games, which, you know, generally bowl games you're even, you know.
Yeah, because they're throwaways. You never know what happens.
He hasn't lost more than one game in the conference since 2010, and that was the only year, I guess his first year, he lost. They took games away or whatever it was, and they were no
But you're good. Speaking to... My answer that all that adds up to just not that's greatness.
Yes,
and again, not close. You had a real good parallel, Bill Belichick, you know, to pro. If Saban had been at Alabama though since '99, he'd have 12 titles. Dan, I mean, the guy wins in a sport that has gotten more than ever. Old Dominion can beat Virginia Tech. Appalachian State can beat Notre Dame. Georgia Southern can beat Florida. More than ever, those possibilities exist. And in that era, he's dominating more than anyone ever has.
It's amazing.
So, yeah, it is unbelievable. All right, last question here on the 10-minute drill.
I'm ready for it.
I'm not going to ask you if you are surprised. I'm going to ask you how shocked you are that a Boston Red Sox Los Angeles Dodgers World Series had the fourth lowest ratings ever, down 25% from last year. Make some sense of that for me.
I really can't. I mean, why would that happen? Look, first off, the Cubs-Indians was a once-in-a-lifetimer, and so that, I think, got great ratings, if I remember correctly, and that was exciting, and so I get that, but this is what you dreamed of. You didn't want Houston and Milwaukee.
Or Atlanta and someone.
They get Boston and L.A. should be absolutely perfect. I think, I don't know, maybe it's, I'm not impressed with Los Angeles sports fans. So maybe that has something to do. Have they checked the L.A. market? Did they not bring it home?
The Lakers always carried great rankings.
The Lakers are the only team they care about out there. Yeah. I don't think they're, even the Dodgers, I just don't think they're huge sports fans in Los Angeles. I think they're I don't think they're true grit, you know, tested, hardcore, I'm going to the Dodger game no matter what fans. I just don't. But I'm grasping for straws here. That's only one market. But maybe you need the second largest market to deliver, and maybe they didn't deliver the number. I don't know. It's a great question. And the World Series, thank you. We've looked at the World Series through years and years, and obviously it's gone down and down and down.
But this would see this just is tailor made for traditionalists, and I'm shocked. Look, if you went into the postseason, Dan, if we went into the postseason, I ask you, which matchup would be best for baseball? Wouldn't that be
sure.
It'd be Dodgers, Red Sox, or Dodgers, Yankees, wouldn't it?
Yes.
So if I'm Major League Baseball today and I'm sitting in the home offices, I'm scratching my head and I'm starting to worry. I don't know how you come back from that.
Well, I think the commissioner said as much.
Yeah. Well, like,
I can't make hide nor hair of this. I don't understand why. I think he said that.
Is it possible people are tired of the Red Sox winning?
No.
They haven't won enough to be. Well, then you would watch because
like
the Dodgers
Yankees
can
always
beat them.
Well, Yankees will always get great ratings.
I think people like dominance. I do. I don't, you know.
Dynasties, like go look at NBA, Golden State.
The Patriots. Those are the most watched games. Yeah. People want to either see them keep winning or see them lose.
Yeah, I don't think that's it. But it's a theory, though. It's weird. I think people are searching, though.
Again, it definitely knocks back that old notion, that old cliche that we always immediately assume about the baseball postseason.
Yeah.
Right? Well, the last thing they won is an Astros-Brewers. I don't think the Astros-Brewers would have gotten worse. In many ways, maybe the refreshing faces would have given it a higher rating. I don't know. But I get surprised a lot in this business. This is about as surprised about a baseball story as that. Fourth lowest ever, Dodgers, Red Sox.
This is an extreme, but, you know, obviously golf recently said, we're not going to compete with football. We're moving our championships up, and that way there's no question that our major championship will be held without people's eyes on football. Any chance baseball ever tries to figure out a way where they're not competing with football?
I don't know how they do. They try, you know. They play games scheduled on Tuesdays and Fridays, the only 2 days where there is no football, maybe. So, but when you get to the weekend, you just got to stand on your own strengths, I guess. You maybe go, you know, we'd suggested before, how about a day game? You know, how about a World Series game at 3:30 in the afternoon?
It would never draw the ratings, though, that.
But against college football, it might, Dan.
Yeah.
But if baseball ended in August?
Oh, you mean on a Saturday?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Play a Saturday afternoon game. They play Saturday nights.
That's one thing.
You know, did you shorten the schedule, ended in August?
No, I would never do that to fight football.
Timelessness of baseball is, I mean, you could go to 100, what they used to do, 154, and they went to 162?
Yeah, they're not going to go backwards.
You could do that, but it's revenue. Yeah, it's revenue.
I don't think that baseball should cap. Look, it's different with golf. You're fifth or sixth in line.
Yeah.
You know, I don't see baseball cowering from another professional sport, but it may help. Although we did say Red Sox Dodgers outdrew Saints Vikings. So if Saints Vikings weren't on, does that game get an 18?
I think it would have done better.
Yeah.
Hey, there are four letters in Gene. We'll take caller number four right now for Kiss tickets. Yeah! 641-1010 is the number to dial. Caller number four, Beef. And we're back with more after this on The Drill.